Good day, everyone. I'm Gabriel Matre from BCP2. So this hour we take up about explanation and demonstration of basic skill. Therefore, I would like to discuss the rules and demonstrate the serving, receiving, scoring, and types of game. But first, let me show you the meaning of table tennis.
Table tennis, also known as ping pong and beanbag, is a sport in which two or four players hit a lightweight ball, also known as the ping pong ball, back and forth across a table using small rackets. The game takes place on a hard table divided by a net. The game is popular all over the world. In most countries, it is very highly organized as a competitive sport, especially in Europe and Asia, particularly in China and Japan.
So let's move on to the next, which is about equipment of the table tennis. So the first equipment of the table tennis is the table. So since na table yung gamit natin, imagine lang natin na ito talaga yung table na ginagamit for this sport. So the measurement of this table is that the length is 9 feet, the width is 5 feet, and the height is 2.5 feet above the floor. So next is the net assembly. So, the net assembly consists of the net, the two poles, and the clubs which is attached from the table. So, the measurement of this whole length of the poles is 15.25 cm. So, the next equipment natin ay ang ball. The ball should be spherical with a diameter of 40 mm or 1.57 inches. The weight is 2.7 grams. So, the ping pong ball is made up of plastic called celluloid. Next is the racket or paddle. So, the paddle has a four parts: the handle, the rubber, the blade, and the sponge. So, the measurement of this full paddle is 10.24 inches, this side is 6.7 inches, and the top is 5.9 inches. While the bottom of the paddle or the handle is 0.94 inches.
Rules of the table tennis. First, games are played to 11 points. A game is played to 11 points. A game must be won by 2 points. A match is generally the best 3 of 5 games. Alternate serves every 2 points. Each side of the table alternates serving 2 points at a time. Exception after tied, or we call deuce. Service alternates at the every point. Can you lose on a serve in ping pong? Yes! There is no separate rule for serving on a game point. Third, toss the ball straight up when serving. How do you serve the ball in ping pong? Hold the ball in your open palm behind your end of the table. Toss at least 6 straight up and strike it on way down. It must hit your side of the table and then the other side. Note, once the ball leaves the server's head in its play, and so counts as the receiver point if the ball is missed or mishit. Fourth, is the serve can land anywhere in singles. There is no restriction on where the ball lands on your side or your opponent's side of the table. It can bounce 2 or more times on your opponent's side. If so, that your point bounce over the side or even hit the edge. Fifth, double serves must go right court to the right court. The serve must bounce in the server's right court and receiver right court. Note, landing center line is fair. Doubles partner switch places after 13 serves twice. Six, a serve that touches the net on the way over is a let. Can the ball hit the net in a ping pong? Yes, during a rally. If it touches the top of the net and the otherwise lands as a legitimate hit, but not when serving. If a serve ball hits the net on the way over the otherwise legally bounces a play, it is a let, serve, and it's done over. There is no limit of how many times this can happen. 7. Alternate hitting in a doubles rally. doubles partners must alternate hitting balls in a rally, no matter where the ball lands on the table. 8. Volleys are not allowed. Can you hit the ball before it bounces in the ping pong? No. In regular tennis, you may volley the ball, hitting the ball before it bounces on your side of the net. But in the table tennis, this results in a point of your opponent. 9. If your hit bounces back over the net by itself, it is your point. If you hit the ball in rally or on a serve and it bounces back over the net after hitting your opponent's side of the table due to extreme spin without your opponent touching it, that is your point. Touching the ball with your paddle hand is allowed. What happens if the ball hits your finger or hand during the ping pong rally? If the ball touches your paddle hand and otherwise resolved in a legal hit, there is no rule violation and play shall continue as normal. 11. You may not touch the table with your non-paddle hand. You may not touch the table or the table with your paddle hand after reaching in return a short serve, for example, or other parts of your body. 12. An edge ball bouncing off the horizontal table top surface is good. An otherwise legal serve or hit may contact the top of the edge of the horizontal table top surface and be counted as valid. Even if bounces sideways, the vertical sides of the table are not part of the legal playing surface. And lastly, honor system applies to the segments. If no referee is present during a match and the player disagree on a certain call, the honor system applies and the player should fight a way to agree.
So let's move on to the rules of serving, receiving, scoring, and types of games. Ang una nating rules ay sa serving. Sa pag-serve, kailangan naka-open pa at natin din naka-close dahil siya illegal. At ang taas dapat niya ay 6 inches. At sa pag-serve, dapat hindi sa loob ng surface ng table, dapat ay nasa labas o kaya nasa gilid. At babalita akong bola dito sa ilalim kasi hindi makikita na kalaban. Like this one. So next, the rules for receiving. So sa receiving naman, ay kailangan mo lang ibalik na maayos yung bola dun sa surface ng table ng kalaban mo. At for example, ay sa nerve niya, hindi mo na kailangan patalbogin dito yung bola at kailangan diretso na sa kabila sa inyong kalaban. So next, the rules for scoring. So sa scoring naman, ang table tennis ay up to 11 points. So the first player who got 11 points to the second player ay siyang panalo. Unless the both players are tied to the score of 10-10 or equal deuce. Then the game will be won by the first player or pair to gain a 2-point lead. And for example of scoring ay yung sa tinatawag natin na net. Yung kapag tumama yung bola dito sa net at pumasok doon sa kabilang side ng kalaban, may wala score yun at ulitin mo yung impact. Then another example ay yung tinatawag natin na line ball. For example, is ito yung line and then nag-serve ka at pinapas ng kalaban pero pumasok doon sa kabilang side, score mo yun.
So, what is the grip? Basically, the grip is a kind of method of holding the paddles. There is a various kinds of grips in table tennis that are innovated by different players at different times.
So, alas natin ang types of grips. Meron tayo tatlo types of grips. Ang shaker grip, pendulum grip, at ang similar grip. So, magsimula muna tayo sa shaker grip. Sa shaker grip ay meron 2 types. Ang grip shake and grip at ang shadow shake and grip. So ito ang tamang pagkapit sa grip shake and grip. So sa forehand. So keep the forefinger close to the paddle edge at sa backhand naman, keep the top of the rubber and wrap the other 3 fingers around the handle. Grip shake and grip. So next is the shallow shake and grip. So sa paghahawak ng shallow second grip sa forehand, keep the forefinger close to the paddle's edge and thumb press on the handle and wrap the other three fingers around the handle. So next, the pedal grip. So sa paghahawak ng pedal grip sa backhand, hold the paddle like you hold a pen like this. And sa forehand naman, spread other three fingers which stand from one another. Pedal grip. Three is the simulant grip. So sa paggawa ng simulant grip, it's like the shaken grip, which is the shallow shaken grip. So sa forehand, keep the forefinger close to the paddle edge, which is the backhand naman. Thumb rest on the handle and wrap the other three fingers around the handle. Simulant grip. And that's all. Thank you.